Hey everybody, in this video I'm going to be taking a look at Epic Little War Game, which was just recently released on Steam, and is one of these cool little turn-based pocket strategy games in the vein of classics such as Advance Wars. I really like games of this sort because they scratch a particular itch that I have, which is that I really am a big fan of small-scale, tactical, squad, turn-based strategy games. And I'm also a big fan of those sorts of games that employ some form of cooperative play. And the nice thing about this game versus its predecessor is that it actually has a multiplayer and specifically cooperative component to it. Now, unfortunately, the cooperative component is less of a campaign and more of just the ability to play co-op versus a couple of bots in one-off missions. But with the inclusion of a random map generator and some other neat little features that are representative of a game that's a sequel in a series, I think Epic Little War Game does a pretty good job of moving this basic concept forward, just enough to get it to the point where I can pretty easily recommend it to you folks. Now, I do have to say that despite this game being presented as a full finished product, i.e. not being released into something like Early Access, I have found there to be a few technical issues and missing features with the game that are worth pointing out. I've had some issues with sound playback under various circumstances where there'll be sort of crackling or popping noises coming out of either the left speaker or the right speaker or both under various circumstances. I have found that restarting the game sometimes clears up a lot of those sound issues. But at the same time, even under the best of circumstances, you'll still hear occasional clicking and popping and such, depending on your particular hardware configuration. That's definitely something that the developers are aware of. There's a few threads on the Steam forums about it. They seem to be working actively to try to combat that issue, and I feel reasonably confident that they'll probably be able to work it out at some point, but it is something worth noting. At launch, there was also an issue with the game involving shaders that was causing explosions to render slowly under certain circumstances, but I believe that issue has been fixed as of the game's first patch. There's also an issue regarding the rendering of flags, where the flags for various teams are showing up as black textures instead of showing the patterns and colors that they should be. You can actually see some of that here in this footage. And there have also been reports of some issues with online play not working under all circumstances. And I will say from my own personal experience, there do seem to be some absent features in the online, such as the ability to have a friends list and join friends' games directly and set up private games with friends and that sort of thing. So while I do think this game is pretty good and a nice step forward for the series, I feel as though it's a bit incomplete and a bit rough around the edges in its current state. So it's definitely going to be important for you to go into it understanding that and accepting that the game may not be quite everything you're hoping for, at least as it currently stands. The good news is this is a $10 game, which is currently being sold at a 20% discount on Steam. So I picked this thing up for 8 bucks and I'm still having quite a bit of fun with it. It's just a little disappointing that the game isn't quite as polished or as refined or as thoroughly tested as one might hope, especially for a sequel in a series. However, having said that, I can't understand how a lot of the new features they're trying to implement in this game could lead to some problem areas and some technical issues that they may not have had to face before as a small indie developer. My general inclination here is to kind of give them the benefit of the doubt and figure that they'll probably work this stuff out, hopefully in the short term or at least eventually. I'm definitely very happy and pleased to see another game of this sort being released on Steam, because as far as I'm concerned, co-op friendly turn-based strategy games are all too rare on Steam these days, so any sort of title that tries to tread that ground is a welcome addition in my book. And I do have to say that despite the technical issues or any other sort of problems I've had with this game, I have found it to be very fun and engaging and pleasant to experience for the most part. I think that's going to do it for me for this initial impression on Epic Little War Game. Hopefully you folks have enjoyed it. If you did, be sure to hit that like button. If you'd like to see more videos from me in the future, be sure to hit subscribe, and I will see you next time.
Yes, sir! Take her down!
Damn the devil, what killed you?
Yes, sir!
You got me!
Let's do this! Itching to fight in my life.
Better be good. I'd buy that for a dollar.